Oh boy. I hope and pray. I think I'm hung. Yep, sure am. That right there is what heartbreak feels like. Timber trout, native species. Disgusting. How's it going, everybody? Welcome to the channel. If it's your first time, if you are a new fisherman that is just learning and just wanting to start out, this is the video for you. Today I'm going to show you how to tie on your hook, how to apply some basic kinds of weights, and a couple of different ways as well that you can tie on those baits in terms of, like, you know, for the different kind of situations you're going to be fishing in. I'm going to grab a couple different kinds of, you know, baits that we can try on. We'll grab the worm. And we'll grab some swimming type baits as well. All right, so let's go through some of the basics here that you're gonna need. First of all, your line. I just have this spooled up to this. My other two rods have braid on it right now, but it'll still work just as fine to show you how to tie that on. We got some hooks here. This is an extra wide gap hook. I believe this is a 3/0. And we got a couple different bullet weights here. The smaller one that you can see is a 1/4 ounce bullet weight. That's what I'm gonna use the vast majority of the time. And you got a 1/2 ounce right here too. 1/2 ounce is good for like punching rigs, drop shots, that kind of thing. But for just like, you know, normal, you know, run of the mill, regular setups, I'm going with that 1/4 ounce pretty much every time. All right, so first things first, we got our line here. Just like some basic mono. I think it's like 10, 12 pounds. Yeah, 12. So you can see kind of here on the top of this bullet weight, I've got my entry hold at the top. I'm going to put it nose in first and feed it through that line. Boom. So there's our bullet weight just sitting there on the line. That's all we got to do. You can just feed that down the rest of the line. Now we're moving on to the hook. So we've got our hook and our line. Obviously we got that hole in the top for the hook, and I'm just going to take the edge of my line and I'm going to feed that through. When I feed it through, I'm going to take my tag end here. I'm gonna pull that out about 3-4 inches. You can see I got a good bit of space there. All right, so now we're gonna get into tying up that knot. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna, while I'm holding my lead over here, got the bottom there, but this is my lead tag end. I'm gonna keep that nice and tight on this edge, and I'm gonna hold the hook here. So I give myself, you know, a decent bit of room there. And what I'm gonna do is I'm going to start rotating this hook. And I'm gonna continue to rotate it 3-4 times. Unless I drop it. I'm gonna rotate it 3-4 times. And now you can kind of see we've got a little threaded line right there, and then we've got a hole in the top. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take that tag end that I have still in my left hand right here, and we're gonna feed that through that loop that you see right there. You reposition it just a little bit. There we go, now you can see it a little bit better. So you can see the line. So I'm gonna take my tag end, I'm gonna feed it right through that loop, grab it, pull it tight. So what I like to do is, you know, just take this top part like in my teeth and then hold this part just like this, and then I'll kind of cinch it down that way too. It just makes for like a little bit of a tighter like grip on it. So for that same thing we just did, I'm gonna do it again. I like to do it like anywhere from like 2 to like 4 times. It really just depends what I've got tied on. So same thing as before. You know, taking that thing, we're looking for that hole at the top, and I'm just gonna get to twisting this hook. We've got our little space at the top there to loop it through. I'm gonna loop it through again, grab my tag in again, cinch it down. In my case, I'm gonna bite it and tighten this. Okay, so now it's sealed up, and now if we look here at the top, we've got a nice little knot there, and that's not going anywhere. All right, so now we're gonna clip off our remaining tag end. Boom, that's done. Fingernails are a must for your tackle box. It just makes for really easy flips and stuff. And now we've got our hook and our weight set on. It'll look just like that. The weight obviously slides, there's nothing attaching to it, and that hook's gonna sit just like that. All right, so now let's tie on some baits. I grabbed some of these Lunker Hunt worms. I got these out of a Monster Bass box. Shout out Monster Bass. I'm not sponsored. I will be one day though. We got it in this blue and black flick. I really like this color. Just kind of looks nice. So there's the worm. Tail end, head end. Head end is obvious because you've got this little kind of flat part here at the top. There's kind of like some stuff off here where it's machine. You can do what you want with that. Buy it off whatever. I don't really bother myself with it. No big deal. Fish don't care either. So what I'm going to do is from this head end, I'm going to take my hook and I'm going to just start working it down until I get to this top section where the hook starts to curve. As soon as I'm there, I'm going to poke it through and start to work that hook through the side just like that. So now I'm through the side and I'm working that worm up the hook. I'm gonna pull it on down and I'm gonna start to rotate it. So my entryway is at the top and now we end up with something just like this. So kind of how this hook is situated on here, while it's not inside the worm on this back side, is how we want it to look once we position the hook. So you notice here, I've covered the whole top of that hook base with this. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take it, I'm gonna squish the worm forward just a little bit so I have a little bit of extra room. And then I'm gonna start feeding that hook through the bottom. Okay, so now my hook's starting to come through and I'm just going to pull it on down and flatten that out. And now you got a nice straight worm on there. So, and how we're going to be running this particular one and the swim bait that I'm in, shad style bait that I'm going to show you in a second, is we want this hook to be covered. This is known as running a bait weedless. Basically, it means that it's going to protect this hook from snagging on a cover, grass, like that kind of thing. So I'm just going to pull it up, shoot it forward, and pull it back. Okay, so now the barb head is covered in that. I can run my finger across it and I'm not going to get hooked. And I'm just going to squish it forward and I'm all good. So now I got that worm rigged up, my hook is hidden, and whenever I hold the rod and my bait comes down, this is how it's going to sit in the water. This is going to be kind of the presentation. You can imagine, like, when you cast it in, that weight is going to start to lead this down, right? And so when it lands in the bottom, you know, you got your worm suspended in the water kind of like this, and you can start working it across the bottom or however way you really want to. So that's our rigging right there. Super simple. So let's take the worm off. I'm just going to throw something else on there just to show you an example of something else. I really like this worm though. Worms are great. If you're looking, there's a billion different colors of baits and things like that. If you don't know, just go Green Pumpkin. You can't go wrong. All right, so I got my bag of trailers and swim baits and stuff. I'm going to tie on this Guggen. This is a Saucen shad, I believe. Paddle tail there at the end. Really nice action on that. It's the same deal as before. I'm on the head end of this bait of this shad. I'm going to feed it through until I get to the top of the barb. Pull the hook through. I'm there. Now that I got my edge buried in that, got the hook on. Now we're in our pre-hooked position, right? We got the hook right where we want it on the bait. I'm gonna squish the bait up just a little bit before I hook it. And then I'm gonna start to feed it through. Now my hook's coming through the bottom. Bait's sitting straight on the hook. I'm just gonna squish it forward and squish it back. And now my barb is nice and covered. And now we got a little shad swimmer. Same deal as before with the weight. It's gonna swim just like that. It's gonna, you know, at least, like, you know, obviously your retrieve speed plays into this too, but, you know, fishing it slow, you know, the weight's going to drag it down a little bit. You're just going to be dragging it through the water, getting that paddle tail action. You'll be able to cast it a little better too, obviously, with a little bit more weight on the front end. Okay, so that's it, guys. I hope the tutorial, like, helped you guys out. This is the simplest knot that I know how to tie, and I do it all the time. I know there's a billion other videos out there of people doing complicated stuff with their knots and all these other kind of things. To me, I just don't feel like investing in the time to learn all those different kind of ways when I have something simple this way. That's always worked for me. So highly recommend this knot. It's easy. It's good for a quick change on the water or off the bank, anything like that. And it's versatile. You can use it anywhere. Obviously in this particular video, I've tied it onto this wide gap hook, but you can tie the same exact knot on like a swivel or something like that. I like to use these if I'm switching out lures, if that's how you're fishing. You can tie that same exact knot to, you know, like the top section of like a jig head. Let me look in here and pick one out so I can show you. There you go. So I got this jig head right here. You can feed it through the top of that and it's going to be fine. If you want to put it on an actual lure, that's fine too. The knot goes anywhere. It doesn't have to be a particular kind of thing. It also doesn't have to just be a, you know, a mono or fluoro type line. I use the same exact knot for braid too. So you can go anywhere. It's super versatile and it's nice and simple. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a like. If you guys have any questions about equipment or any of the stuff that I showed in the video today, feel free to leave me a comment and I'll get right back to you. So thank you guys a lot and we'll see you back here next time. It's caught in the crossfire.